Sometimes strange things do happen. I was not planning on doing this video tonight. I was actually busy installing switch machines and signals on my layout. And pretty much what it involves is, it's one of them old gotcha kind of things, involves tortoises, bridge rectifiers, a little dwarf signal. It's basically two sets of LEDs purchased off of eBay, and Flux. We'll have a look at what I've been building. I have my tortoise here. I have my signal from eBay. It's basically a ground, or actually, that's actually the positive, and actually grounds off the red and the green lead. Coming into the signal, I have my power leads that will come out of an NCE switch it or something like that, so it's a reversing lead. What I use is a bridge rectifier right here. Use the AC side so it can switch in and out. And what actually comes out of this rectifier is a negative and a positive. I don't know if you can see that very well, if you have ever used rectifiers and stuff like that. But it'll take an AC current and turn it into a DC. Or in this case, on the tortoise, what I'm doing is it's kind of an AC-DC thing. As it switch swaps polarity, it will still keep this lead positive and that lead negative. Pretty cool little device. How it works is you got the two leads coming in. They go to the power leads, the red and the white, into the tortoise that switch it back and forth. As you can see, you have the negative coming out. It goes into the black, which is a center pole on the switch lead. And then you have that coming out as a two, and it's hard to see for you guys, the green and the orange wires into the LED. And then you have the positive, which is the positive lead right here going into the actual signal. I've actually kind of fixed this one, but I'll kind of tell you what was happening. When I was running the leads, so we have a green light. I flip it over, and it should, as the tortoise rotates the other switch side, it should go to red and back to green. Like that. Pretty neat little setup. What was happening was, when I was doing the switch, both lights were staying on, which meant there was somewhere within the system power was getting from one side of the internal switch inside the tortoise to the other lead. So they were actually getting power on both these leads coming, or ground I should say, on both these leads. We're seeing a ground of some sort, and it was activating the turn signal. Took me a little bit to figure it out, and once I figured it out, I was like, kind of stupid, but we'll continue on this little discussion here. Hang on, we'll get the next part out. Here's where things start to get interesting. This one here I put together, and I actually might not do it anymore, but we'll see. You should have continuity of some sort between the two motor leads. Then you have, and most people do this when they check this kind of stuff, these are your two center contacts, and these are your two switch. So I should be able to go one of these. There we go. That's switched. And same thing over here with the black to one of the oranges. Flip it over. And you see where it switched back and forth. None of these share, should connect together. See the blue and the yellow on the switch sides, the green and the orange on the switch sides. So to me it looked like it was good. I had my soldering done, everything was working correctly, but the LED was still getting electricity on both sides are getting aground on both sides of the green and the orange. So naturally, you go to the ohm setting on your meter, and you check it again. So I'm checking it again here. I'm going, okay, we have 0.07 ohms, which means it's shorted or closed, you should say. And then on the other one, the black and the green, I'm getting 7.4K right there. That should not be happening. Same thing here over on this side too. I was like, what the heck's going on? 6. And that's 56. Granted, I've done a little bit of work on these here. Even the two contacts are mated together. So somehow, and I didn't know what was actually internal into a tortoise switch machine. So somehow, current is making its way, leaking into these other contacts. So I ended up taking one of them that I built apart. So in case you guys have never seen what's inside of a tortoise switch machine, here's what you got. You got half the casing, because I was really curious what it was going on inside here. Here's the other half with the gear reductions. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gear reductions on this. This is what gives it slow speed right here. And it's just, I could start counting teeth and tell you exactly how much the reduction is on all this, but I'm not going to do that. That's the other side. It actually came apart really easy. Then you have the actual throw mechanism. It's got the contacts on it. It slides in right here as such. And I won't even try putting it together on camera, but you get the general idea how it works. So I'm looking at the contacts, and then you have the main board here. That's your board with your actual motor on it right there. I looked at it, and there's no way for current to get from one side to the other. It shouldn't happen. So I went and still, on this one here, same deal, checked it. So if I go from, and I can actually do the pads right up here, I'm still getting bleed through this mechanism. And as you follow the traces, there should be no way that this could happen. You should not be able to get a bleed across any of these. And you do it even, I can go across circuits. And that was what was causing my problem. I'm getting bleed, which is, if you're doing signals or you have weird things happening on your layout, you need to look for stuff like that. Why am I getting bleed, current bleed, into one half of the circuit to the other? And if you look at the circuit board, you can see nothing touches. At this point, I decided I'm going to check. And I should have done this beforehand, but I didn't have a new switch laying around. Check that for seeing what's going on with this. We have continuity, but at this point, none of these pads made up. As you can see, there's no shared juice on this other than, or bleed, other than what I'm actually touching. As we go across each one, and there's the motor contact, so we should have something going on. Take one that I've been working on and do the same thing. You can see I'm getting bleed on all these. Even getting bleed from the circuit board itself across this, which should not be happening. And I should point out, I even checked with the magnifying glass and verified that none of these contacts were actually touching. If they were, I'd had a zero ohm type short, but I didn't. Well, the only thing that I did besides solder those leads on there is I used flux. And For the life of me, I don't know why I didn't realize this. Flux conducts electricity. So what I ended up doing is I took my board here. As we know, wood's not very conductive. There we go. Then I took some flux and wiped it on this board. As you can see, but if I move it around a little bit, here's where I wiped it. That's my problem. I was actually, the flux itself is actually completing the circuit within my signal system and was causing my dwarf signal to give me a false red or green with both lights lit. I ended up cleaning them up really well with alcohol and everything, but now that I know this, I'm gonna see if I can solder my leads on without using flux on them, just on so I don't have that issue, and I hope I don't have a problem with that. But that is a serious issue. If you have anything on your layout behaving really weird, it could be just the fact that you have used some flux on it to solder something together. And it wouldn't take much. I mean, literally, I could probably, and I'll do it. Here's a fun little demo. We'll continuity check it really quick. Both tracks are separated. Most people will do this with a little beeper. Nothing happens. Somehow my process of working on the layout, I got flux across a tie, over a switch point. Who knows what happened? If I check it again, hopefully nothing will happen. No beep, we're good. Let's see what happens here when we go on to the actual resistant reading. I now have a short across the rail, from rail to rail. And that's a, what, 150K? And it could be more, could be less. This is N scale. And so the rails are closer together. But if you're working on a frog or something, you're soldering something in, you could end up something even worse than this. As you can see, it's just like a variable resistor. I can move this back and forth along this tie and change my reading. So if you have odd things happening with your signal system, stuff's not behaving right, it could be as simple as flux. In my case, I don't know if all flux do this, but it's shorting, creating a pass for current or something across your rails. I hope this video is helpful. It's just kind of interesting that a simple thing like solder flux can cause an electrical issue on your layout. It's actually conducting electricity from one contact to another, a bleed through type of setup, and messing up my signal system on the layout. Hope the video is helpful. As always, comment down below, thumbs up, thumbs down, you know the routine, and thanks for watching.